Hi everybody, it's Amy and David Brissett with the Brissett Group at Keller Williams here in Austin, Texas. We have been getting lots of questions lately about waiting. Market's gotten really hot, interest rates are moving up, and people are asking, should we wait? So I'm gonna ask Amy, 12-year realtor here in Austin, what do you think? Should you wait, or what advice are you giving clients these days?
What I've been telling them is that we just don't have any indication that the market is changing
right. In
Austin. I mean, we have so many large corporations that are every month announcing that they are moving their headquarters to Austin. We have companies such as Tesla,
Oracle,
Google,
Apple.
Facebook.
Apple's got a new campus coming on, and these moves are just starting to happen. The executives are just starting to come here. There's going to be demand for quite a long time just for the current backlog of people moving here.
Right, and so given that information, it doesn't sound like people are going to stop moving to Austin.
Right.
So then that keeps the demand high, which of course we know is supply and demand, then it makes the prices continue to be high. Now, I do think that given maybe a couple of years, because it is going to take us a couple of years to get in the backlog of people that have been trying to get a house. And when you have, 15, 20 offers per house,
right,
there can only be one winner of that. Then you still have these other 15 or 20 people that are still looking for that type of a house.
And the builders are starting to really get busy. It might be a little more farther out of town. It might be Buda or
Hutto.
Hutto's happening right now.
Gerald's Temple.
Happening.
And then as far south down as New Braunfels, we have people from Austin that are moving that far south. So, give us a couple of years, maybe 2-3 years, and we might be able to catch up with some of that growth by the time builders are, able to actually get a lot of their product on the ground.
Another thing to think about is interest rates. I know interest rates have just now broken 4%. We're in February of 2022, but that is still historically low. I made a little printout here. The median sales price was $604,000. Was that January?
In January.
And
for all of Austin single family properties.
And I was seeing loan approvals, pre-approvals at 3.25, 3.3 back that were still being active back then. If you move to 4.1% on that loan, you're paying $1,650 a month in interest. Now that is about $280 more than that 3.3 interest rate. Going up to 4.5, 4.6%, you're paying $550 to $600 more a month just in interest. So getting it near 4% is still a pretty attractive deal if you can get into housing right now.
Right, and another thing to consider is when people say, well, I'm just going to wait. Okay, so you're gonna wait 2-3 years. But let's look at it in 2020. Okay, we have increased since January of 2020, our median home price has increased 33% since January of 2020. 33%.
I guess what you're saying here is though, if you stretched 2 years ago to make it happen, to get into a house,
you kind of kept fighting for it.
Kept fighting for it. Is at the edge of your ability. Now, 2 years later, you're up 33%. So
right. Hanging
on and saving more for 2 years versus you make a 33% increase in your property value. I mean, you can see what the better bet was historically. No guarantees for the future,
right. But
historically, that's what awesome markets look like.
Right, so I wish we could say, we had this crystal ball and we could say, oh my gosh, you've got to buy, in this time period because the prices will be better. We know that seasonality is definitely a big player in real estate. So for Austin, maybe if you wait until late summer or early fall, you might have some, more choices than in the heat of the, what we call our spring market, which starts in mid-January.
Yeah.
But otherwise, we don't see some big halt or slowdown happening. And so if you are in Austin and you want a house,
If you're in Austin and you want a house and you think you can stretch and make it work, I would definitely look into it and see if it's possible. If you have any specific questions, just write them down in the comments below. We will address your comments and questions and see if we can give you some more specific help. If you're looking for a home in the greater Austin or Hill Country area, Amy and I are here for you, our whole team at the Brissett Group. And we hope you found this information helpful. If you have, like I said, any questions, any comments, just leave them below, and we'll see you next time.
Bye.